Hi, this is Dr. Simon Romero. I'm here to present you the video tutorial for section 12.6, cylinders and quadric surfaces. In this section, we're going to review conic sections, we're going to talk about cylinders, then we're going to talk about quadric surfaces, the general equation, give you some examples of quadric surfaces, and if I'm going to skip the translations and reflections, but you can see it in your notes. We're going to talk as always, I will suggest you to do all the practice problems, and here we go. Traces. A trace of a given surface is a curve obtained by intersecting the surface with a plane. So, for example, in this case, with this plane, the trace corresponding to this plane of this sphere is going to be a circle. Conic sections. A curve obtained by intersecting cone with a plane are called conic sections or conics. So, this is just a quick review of what are conic sections. You are supposed to know this by now. It's just going to be traces of cones, circles, and ellipses that we are going to consider to be the same, parabolas and hyperbolas. Quick features about parabolas. Parabolas look like this, and the thing that you can identify is if A is positive, this parabola is going to open towards the positive y-axis, in other words, up. If A is negative, will open down, and the same thing happens when it opens towards the x-axis or minus x-axis. An ellipse centered at the origin, and the equation is going to be like that. The number A and B are going to describe the length of these two segments, one called the semi-major axis and the other one the semi-minor axis, and technically the thing that it only describes is how we can stretch a circle in order to get an ellipse. One of the features that you have to notice is that two variables are raised to the square and they have a plus in there. And the equation of a hyperbola, the difference between the hyperbola and an ellipse is this. The variables are raised to the square as in the ellipse, but you have a minus here. And this A and B are just going to give you how, kind of like the dimensions of this rectangle over here that is going to generate the asymptotes. So quick feature that you have to see in hyperbola that we're going to find useful is this hyperbola opens towards the x-axis because x, the factor that has x squared here, it has a positive number. I mean, it has a positive sign. When you set it equal to a positive number, the equation. And well, let me just tell you a little bit about cylinders. A cylinder is a surface that consists of four line rulings that are parallel to a given line and pass through a given plane curve. A plane curve is a curve that lies in the plane. So basically, the thing that we're doing is we're taking a plane curve and then we're taking a line that may not be passing through the plane curve, and you are going to take all the lines that do pass, all the lines that do pass through that plane curve, and the thing that you have is this that we call a cylinder. A cylinder has the property that you have a particular plane drawing, and the only thing that is happening is this plane drawing is repeating itself along the particular direction of the line. Sketching simple cylinders is pretty easy. The only thing that you have to do is do this. So you have this equation, and you may say this equation is a parabola, but not in the three-dimensional space. The thing that I can say is that in the YZ plane, this is a parabola. But notice that if I take a different trace, the trace when x is equal to 1, still it's going to be the same parabola as well as in the trace of x equal to minus 1. So notice that all the traces are going to have exactly the same parabola when you take traces parallel to the YZ plane. And the thing that you have is a cylinder that has a base, a parabola as a base. So this is the ugly version of it, and then we move on. So cylinders that have conic bases are going to be examples of quadric surfaces. A quadric surface is a surface that is represented by a second degree equation. This is a very complicated formula. The thing that we're going to do is we're going to align our quadrics with the coordinate axis, and that will make these mixed terms to disappear. And we're going to put the center at the origin, and then possibly some of these terms will disappear too, depending on the quadric surface. Let me start with the first one, the ellipsoid. Let me give you, that's the equation, and let me just analyze a little bit this equation. Notice that the thing that we have is the traces parallel to the coordinate planes. The thing that we're doing is with set C equal to K in order to get the traces parallel to the xy plane. And the thing that you obtain is you obtain an ellipse here. Notice that when I solve, I put all the variables in one side and all the constants in the other one. You have something that looks like an ellipse, x squared plus y squared over 4. So this is an ellipse. This is another ellipse. And this is another ellipse by the same reason. So you have all the traces are ellipses, and that's what we obtain over here. So ellipsoids are pretty easy to identify. They almost look like spheres, but with different coefficients for the variables. Elliptic paraboloids, the way that we're going to identify these is, first of all, notice that one variable is not raised to the square. That's going to make the sum of the traces to be parabolas. So let me tell you which ones. So for example, the first one is when we put, instead of C, a constant, the thing that you have is an ellipse, because the two variables are raised to the square and with a plus. This one, it gives you a parabola, but it gives you a parabola that opens towards the positive C, as well as the other one also opens towards the positive C. So the thing that you have is two parabolas that open towards the positive C, so you have something that looks like a bowl, just like this. And let me just show you more or less where are these traces. For example, the XC trace is going to be a parabola opening towards the positive C axis. So we have this parabola over here. The other one, the blue one, is going to be also a parabola opening towards the C axis. So you have two parabolas opening towards the C axis, and that gives you this bowl shape. Let me move to the hyperbolic parabola. Notice that in the hyperbolic parabola we have the same feature, but we have this minus over here. This minus over here is going to create two things. We're still going to have the parabolas, but in the other trace is going to be a hyperbola. That's hence the name hyperbolic parabola. So notice that you have a hyperbola here, and here you have two parabolas, one opening towards the negative C axis because of the minus, and the other one opening towards the positive C axis. And the thing that that's going to give you is this saddle shape, figure. Let me just tell you the parabolas. So the XC traces are going to give you parabolas opening downwards. So let me just tell you, this is the parabola that we're talking about. The YC traces are going to be, they're going to give you parabolas opening upwards, that gives you something like this, and that will create that saddle shape that we have over here. Let me go to the cones. The cones are going to be almost look like an elliptic paraboloid, but C is raised to the square. So in other words, the thing that we have here is that we no longer are going to have parabolas as traces, because there is not that difference between one raised to the square and the other one not raised to the square. So let me give you the traces, and again, we're going to highlight the important parts. First one is an ellipse, and the other ones are going to be hyperbolas, because you have a minus once you solve for the variables, putting the variables in one side and the constants on the other side. So you have ellipse, hyperbola, and hyperbola, and that will give you a cone. Later on, we're going to try to identify more about how to identify the cones a little bit better, but for right now, I just want to keep it like that. Let me talk about hyperbolas of one shape. So let me start with this, and I'm going to tell you what are the traces for this. Notice that the traces for this, we have an ellipse here, x squared plus y squared, so that gives you an ellipse. And now let me go to the hyperbolas. Notice that in here, the first hyperbola is opening towards the x-axis, and the second hyperbola is opening towards the y-axis. So notice that this is going to give you something like this. Let me just show you here what is happening. In the xc trace, you're going to have a hyperbola opening towards, you're going to have a hyperbola opening towards the x-axis, and the other one is going to be a hyperbola opening towards the y-axis in the yz plane, that is the one that we have here. So notice that the thing that that's going to do is it's going to give us this water coolant shape, because these hyperbolas are opening towards different axes. That's the hyperbola of one sheet. It's called hyperbola of one sheet. First of all, hyperboloid, because the two traces are hyperbolas, and of one sheet because it is in one piece. you will see what happens with the hyperbola of two sheets. So again, two traces are going to be hyperbolas, but notice that these hyperbolas, one is going to open towards the x-axis and the other one also is going to open towards the x-axis in the two different traces, and the last one is an ellipse. I'm not going to pay too much attention to that one, but let me tell you what's going to what, why these two hyperbolas opening to different places is going to give us an answer of our question of why the shape is the way it is. So notice that this is a hyperbola, these xy traces are hyperbolas opening towards the x-axis in the xy plane, or planes parallel to the xy plane, and the other one is going to be hyperbolas in the xz plane that also open towards the x-axis. That gave us this kind of like two separated disks, and that gives us the two sheets that the name say. So the idea is hyperboloid because it has two hyperbolas and two sheets, because these two hyperbolas open towards the same axis. So let me give you a quick overview. Ellipse, ellipse, ellipse gives you an ellipsoid, because it does look like a kind of like a modified sphere. The next two are parabola, parabola. Two parabolas give you a paraboloid, and an ellipse give you an elliptic paraboloid. Again, how to identify it is you have a plus and you have a variable that is not raised to the square. On the x square and y square have the same sign. That would be a better description. Then the other one is parabola, parabola again, but now the two variables that are raised to the square have different signs. So the thing that you have is a hyperbola because of that, and you get an hyperbolic paraboloid. Then the last three have the same traces. So let's try to figure out how to distinguish them. The cone, you cannot set it equal to 1. Notice that that's the case. It will, if I send the C to the other side, you have a 0. The other ones can be set equal to 1, and the difference is the number of signs. If it's set equal to 1, one has one sign and the other one has two signs. This is going to help us to distinguish between the hyperbola one sheet, one sign, two sheets, two signs. But the formal definition is just because the two signs are going to create two hyperbolas that have the same axis that they are opening, and the one sign is going to give you two hyperbolas that open towards different axes. And that's kind of like the way that we can distinguish this. And with this, I finish this quick tutorial about quadric surfaces. Thank you very much.